Hi everyone, this is Lauren with Tripleseat. In this video, we will review how to create documents within events. Documents are how you detail out an event in Tripleseat, and the information added will push to your reporting. Documents are also how you can share information on an event with both your customer as well as your team. These documents, detailed out by users in Tripleseat, are going to include all of the pricing, event notes, billing details, terms and conditions, and any attachments that you have added. So now that we've created our event in Tripleseat, we're going to click into the Documents tab to detail it out. Next, you will click Add a Document to this event over on the right. This template can be thought of as the editing stage of documents. You, as the Tripleseat user, are able to come through and detail out the documents with as much or as little information that you have at the time. Tripleseat documents are customizable to best fit your business needs. You'll learn in a later video exactly how you can customize your documents in your site settings. At the top here is an automatically generated box with your guests and your own contact information. Below are some basic event details. Both of these boxes are going to pull to headers at the top of your different document layouts. Throughout the document template, you will see two different types of fields for you to input information. The first will be text boxes. These are intended for you to input any event notes that you have. Popular example of event notes would be general special instructions, setup notes, and billing notes. There is also a text box intended for your kitchen staff to note of any allergies or special requests on the menu. Typically, these notes can only be seen on an internal layout called the kitchen sheet. On any of the text boxes, you're able to stylize the notes by making them bold, changing size or color, using bullets or numbers to organize, inserting hyperlinks, or adding photos from your file library. For example, you might add a popular floor plan from your file library to the setup notes on this event. The second type of field to input information is going to be pick list fields, with options to add from pick list or add freehand line items. These boxes are intended for adding event charges or pricing. Popular examples of pick lists that you might be adding from would be food and beverage menus, equipment rental, or room rental pricing. If we click Add from pick list, all of the preloaded pricing from our settings is going to appear. You can click into each one of these lists and either add the items individually or all at once by clicking Check All. If your pick lists have headers, as we see here with first course, entrees, and desserts, and you want the headers to show on your documents, make sure you're selecting them in addition to your other line items. Once added, you can edit the description of any item or adjust the pricing, and know that this will only make a change for this event. It's not going to impact existing or future events with this same menu. You're able to expand each item to adjust the billing that defaults from settings and add discounts as well. We will get into more detail on discounting line items in a later video. Be sure to put a quantity next to any charge that has a price associated with it so that you'll see a total populate. If you are adding a charge that is not an existing pick list, you can always utilize Add Freehand and manually type in the quantity, description, price, and assign a menu item category before adding. Towards the bottom is your billing widget. Here you can see the subtotal, which is calculating a total of whatever is above it. Here's where you can also adjust or delete billing details per event, and these changes will not affect your settings or other events. Below the billing details is your grand total, which is the total of everything above it. Next will be any deposits that were built into your documents. If you need help adding additional deposits, please reach out to our support team. On each event, you can change what the amount of the deposit is and set a due date. Please note that if you are entering a percentage for the deposit amount, this is going to calculate from your grand total. Finally, you will review your terms and conditions for this event. The terms that show by default are set up in your document settings, but can be adjusted per event and will not impact your settings or any other events. If your group utilizes different terms and conditions per event type, You can set up what are called content templates or save text to easily drop into this event. Content templates can be set up for any frequently used text. When you are finished putting in the information that you have, make sure you click save so that these changes stick. Whenever you need to make a change to the document on this event, come back into the Docs tab and click onto the contract and event order title to do so. When you make those updates, any changes will push to all of your layouts at once. If you want to see how this information is going to look on the customer's end before you share with them, you can click into the names of any of the layouts to check out what the live version of each document looks like. In the next video, we will cover how you can share this information with your customer. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions, please reach out to our support team, support@tripleseat.com, or by clicking on the help question button on the top right corner of any screen in Tripleseat.